Hi everyone, Matt Nass here, and we are going to be jamming with Planeswalker decks today, so I'm going to try and brew some up. I think Jeskai is a good place to start, and Grixis may also have some value. Just gotta kind of figure things out a bit. But let's start with Jeskai. So the way I'm going to handle this is kind of similar to the way I handled the Troll deck yesterday, and that's Feasting Troll King deck yesterday. And that's just like building a baseline list that's kind of stockish and then trying to iterate over time. Super Friends is my favorite. Oh, sweet, Wikipedia. Yeah, you should enjoy this then. Hopefully we can find a sweet list. Are you on deck for Modern? Any Modern? I generally don't do Modern on my streams during the day. But I would like to do a Modern stream with Sam and BK. Not sure when that will be, since it's kind of up to them. But I would like that to happen. So, maybe I can even sucker them into doing it tonight. Or I have an Underlords tournament that I'm playing tomorrow. And I was thinking if I die in the Underlords tournament, Modern after that might be good. So not sure on the timing. Yeah, the Esper Eggs deck looks really cool. Definitely on my to-do list for decks to play. So first let's kind of handle the slam dunks. Narset, if we're doing Jeskai to start. Narset is a slam dunk, Sarkhan is a slam dunk. And then Teferi is obviously a slam dunk, wherever it is. Here, we can put the Jeskai filters on. That could help. Yeah. So those are the slam dunk planeswalkers. Those are the ones that you're, like, not going to cut. Period. You know, like, no matter what the circumstances are. Oh, interesting. Yeah, well, that would be a good one to try for this then. Oh, yeah. I want to play with the Wish Fairy. I can't spell fairy though. What is it? Oh, I have Planeswalker on. Okay, that's why it's not showing up. Ah, I'm clicking too many buttons. So then for the other Planeswalker, let's talk about the Planeswalkers first. So other Planeswalkers to consider. Gideon, I think, is pretty bad in these decks. So yeah, maybe we'll move one second to the board or whatever, but we can figure that out later. Teo is too bad, I think. Ajani is bad. Wanderer is maybe a sideboard card, but generally bad. Is this thing good? Until your next turn, up to one target creature gets -2/-0 and loses flying. Create a 3/3. Nah, this is not good. Okay, Narset is good. Jace, I think, is bad. Kasmina is okay. I like that Kasmina costs 4, so it's like the perfect cost for playing the turn you play Fires. Oh yeah, that is Brutal Station. Yeah, it is a lot of rares. So yeah, we can pull out Kasmina as a possibility. Chandra seems bad. Tybalt's definitely bad. Other Chandra also seems bad. Jaya seems bad as well. Oh, I should also turn Uncollected on since I don't actually own all the Eldraine cards yet. The last Chandra, though, actually might be playable. Awakened Inferno. And if we're playing Fae of Wishes, it'll almost certainly belong in the sideboard. Dovin Grand Arbiter and Dovin Hand of Control are both decent. They're not great, but they're not horrible either. The other kind of cheap Planeswalker people have played in the past is the 3-mana ones is Saheeli, but that was partially with Mox Amber, so I don't think Saheeli will be good anymore. If you want a Planeswalker that kind of like produces blockers, Dovin is probably your best. This Dovin has to be better than this Dovin, right? Like, I think it is. So yeah, maybe that one. Ashiok is sideboard card max. Saheeli seems bad. Royal Scions is one that I'm like not sure about. The pump ability is going to be pretty bad, so it's mostly just a consistent looter. I don't know if you need the Ronus part of that thing, GL, but Fire's Red Cavalier is definitely good, and whether Ronus is too cute or not is TBD, but that is definitely a good direction to go with the Fires. I'm trying Planeswalkers for now, but yeah, that's definitely appealing. Another thing to think about is that Oko is a really busted Planeswalker. So, like, when we're building these Planeswalkers control decks, we haven't really considered green in the past, but there is a busted green Planeswalker now, so that's, like, something to consider. So maybe we just don't need more Planeswalkers than this. Maybe we can just get away with this as our core. I don't think you need millions of Planeswalkers, right? Like, this sounds like a reasonable configuration. Then we definitely want Clarion. That seems like let's turn off the Planeswalker filter if we think there's a chance that this is all we're going to run. We definitely want Fires. That's a no-brainer. The Fae of Wishes is really good with Fires, I think, and like a natural blocker for this deck. And then we want some removal. Probably a mix of like Shocks and there's actually a new DL3 that I think might be good. What's it called? Scorching Dragonfire, is that it? Yeah, this seems good. This seems better than the alternatives. Okay, so we can jam something like this. And then this would be 56 cards, but that's if we were playing 24 lands. We want closer to 28, I think. So this is about the right number of cards. Maybe we can fit one more. What's a juicy one? Is there something sweet we can play? We could play one copy of the Giant. I want to try that card because it seems pretty fun. Oh no, my Mythic Wild cards. Yeah, whatever. So yeah, the Giant is a Wrath effect that can also be played as like a big threat. Seems better than like Time Wipe or whatever in this deck. Although Time Wipe picking up the Fairy is kind of cute. Okay, so then for the sideboard, this is where things get interesting. So I know from when I played this during the streamer event, we got Chance for Glory a lot. So I definitely want that one. Then I'm trying to think of other cards that we got. The Elder Spell seems too high impact not to run. Yeah, we probably don't want the color filters for this part. Then, like, we want a sweeper, and Kaya's Wrath is just the most efficient sweeper, I think. Oh, yeah, that's true. Well, we're playing the main deck, so the Fae part doesn't matter, but Narset is relevant. Maybe we should just play Time Wipe if we're going to play one. And then in the sideboard, and we could have a Time Wipe, but that seems kind of loose. And then what other bullets do we think we'll tutor for a lot? Chandra, Awakened Inferno seems like a pretty clear one that we'll get a lot. Oh, I already put that one in. Okay. I could see moving a Sark into the board, but I think it's just such a good card to draw, and the Fae of Wishes thing is just not that important. Probably some sort of life gain thing. Enter the God Eternals is coming to mind. Why not play Justice Strike? This thing can hit Planeswalkers. That's a pretty big difference. If you want a cheap... Trophy is something that I was considering. That's one that I'm not sure. Oh, you know what might be, like, a high-impact card that, like, is occasionally great? Casualties of War. That card is... Like, that's the type of thing you want for the sideboard, right? Cards that are sometimes tens. If you want max life gain, there's, like, Pulse of Murasa, but I think Enter the God Eternal should be enough. Some sort of counterspell makes a lot of sense, like Jovan's Veto. This is not so much for when you have the fire, since you can't actually use counterspells then, but just when you're Fang on the normal. Because we also have to consider that. So we should have a sweeper that we can actually cast in our deck as well, right? So, like, and maybe that means that Kaya's Wrath is a spew, because, like, it's only when we have exactly four lands that will come up. Maybe that comes up enough, but I kind of want to save the sideboard slot. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, Command the Dreadhord is another super high-impact card in certain situations. That seems worth having. So then, we're probably going to play Best of One like we did yesterday, but let's just pretend that we were building a real sideboard, since I think we should try to play with, like, the low number of bullets. So I think Vantress Gargoyle is the single best card against aggressive decks, and we should just have four in our sideboard. And then the rest of our sideboard can be, like, extra Dovin's Vetoes, or maybe, like, Aether Gust, or we could play the other one too, the white one. Why am I blanking on names? This thing. Yeah. I guess we could just play one of all of these, and then we can just bring them in as well as having access to them in the board. All right, we'll try something like this. And then we need to do the mana base. That's the last thing. So we definitely want all the shocks. Then we have to figure out if we want, like, Fabled Passage or Temples, or like how we want to handle the rest. So let's pull out one temple at least for each of the colors that have temples. So yeah, we're gonna have the max shocks. Fabled Passage is really good. Oh, your camera's off center, it's triggering me. Yeah, the cleaner. I have cleaners who come every other Friday, and they came and I think they moved my camera while cleaning. So yeah, I'm happy to fix that. By the way, for those of you wondering what to craft from this set, craft Fabled Passage. That's my number one piece of advice. Oh yeah, Interplanar Beacon. Yeah, that's probably a 4 of here. We do have some, like, mildly hard to cast spells that are not beaconable, like Time Wipe, but we don't have a lot of copies, so it should be fine. Fabled is the number one card I would craft. I don't know what you're talking about, Lynn Tobias. That sounds interesting. Yeah, I think in this case it's just, like, play a bunch of good cards, and, like, this deck just has a high mana curve. So it just, like, gets good value out of it. It's not, like, trying to abuse it. It's just an insane mana card, right? How much mana will Fires produce over the course of the game in this deck? I think it's going to be, like, astronomically high. So I don't think we need so many basics. So it could just be this. 4 Passage and 1 of each temple. We could play, like, 2 of the temples and then 2 passages. I guess right now we're off center. We have both red temples, so we're heavy red. So, like, this would be a perfectly balanced mana base if we want that. But white is also our lightest color, so it doesn't really make sense to play 2 planes. We could also play 2 of the blue-red temple, given that white is our lightest. This is also 4 Fabled Passage with 5 fetchables. Maybe one more fetchable is nice. Yeah, this looks scientific. Alright, we'll start there. By the time Gradwick comes into play, X is 0. So you'll draw 0 cards regardless of what you paid. Oh, I see. Yeah, I was wondering about that. I thought it was templated very weirdly. I thought it might be like draw cards equal to its power or something. That is what they wanted to do. So I think I'm still going to do best of one. It's just way better for iterating on a deck. Oh, yeah, I don't know how that's supposed to work, Melrose. That's a good question. My assumption is that you can choose to cast one half or the other for the appropriate cost. Yeah. Yeah, Fires is a wonky card. Oh, I also didn't update Stream Decker. Sorry, I'm so bad at that. One of these days I'll learn how to update Stream Decker. Okay, so I think what we need to do is we need to get one Fabled Passage out of the way. Oh, well, now we don't even have to. Yeah, now we just go Sacred Foundry tapped, and we just know that both of these Fabled Passage will come in untapped. That's nice. If we hadn't drawn a land there, we would play one Fabled Passage and hold the other one. But this makes things easier. Yeah, counterspells are a bit awkward with fire, so that's one thing to consider with the vetoes in the sideboard. Maybe that we want different cards. Yeah, they do. So, I just found that it was better. Like yesterday when we were playing with the Troll King deck, it felt pretty good. I mean, Planeswalkers is a deck that is going to have good game ones. Excuse me, because it's creatureless. So that is something to consider. But I at least like playing a few game ones just to make sure the deck is like functional. We could switch to best 2 out of 3, like, you know, after 2 or 3 games. So against this deck, we're not too likely to Teferi minus, but they're also not too likely to kill the Teferi. So I think just plussing, and they might play like a Field of the Dead next turn. Oh, so I forgot. I guess Teferi is a lot more likely to die in this new world. So maybe we shouldn't be so... Oh, they did also have the field, so you're right about that. So we should definitely play Fires. I think it's probably worth also just playing Shock as a life gain spell. I think it's worth it. Yeah, it is something that you can do. You can play 2 spells off Fires, then Teferi bounce the Fires. And then like play spells with your actual lands. Not gonna come up too often, but it's a nice play to be aware of. Okay, there's Hydroid Crassus. Oh, the Blast Zone can potentially take out. So we actually have a pretty nice sequence set up here. We can go Chandra plus Shock on turn 6. But we're still falling pretty far behind, so I'm still a little concerned about our situation. And so this is the type of spot where it's good to think about. Like, let's say we had Fae of Wishes, what would we want to wish for? Is there something we'd want in our sideboard to have access to? I can't think of something that's obviously great here, other than a sweeper. Oh, one thing that we could have in the sideboard is a land. Like, if we're on 5 lands and have Chandra, or 4 lands and have Sark in it, we would probably Fae of Wishes for a land. Oh, that steals any... They stole my land! Wow, they're denying me the... Okay, well, I guess we... got there, so to speak. We can Clarion plus plus Shock here. Clear things up. Yeah, I don't know why our opponent didn't steal Fires. Maybe they thought that the like restrictions on it would be bad for them. But that seems a little odd to me. I guess we're just dead. We can't answer the Crassus, and we can go to 8 off the beacon. I guess I could have played beacon last turn. I thought thinning my deck might be more relevant. Oh, Planar Cleansing, yeah, that's an option. Yeah, we'll jam one more in the normal queue. Yeah, maybe given that the rider exists, I should just minus Teferi on an empty board more. Yeah, I have Time Wipe instead because you can hit it off Narset. And in the sideboard, you can't play Realm Cloak Giant because the fairy can't get it. It doesn't count as a non-creature, even though half of it is. I snap kept this hand. This hand isn't actually very good.
I can't cast the Shock or Scorching Dragonfire, but we have a good number of sources, so I guess I'll just have faith in the top of my deck. Yeah, I just know I would be so tilted if I... yeah, I guess we go Teferi here. I just know I would be so tilted if I hit a giant with Narset when there was a giant board in play and then couldn't do it. I guess if they have Arclight Phoenix in their deck, this will be good against that too. That's kind of nice. So I think we should just go ahead and use Narset here. Obviously, there is a risk that they can nug Narset, but I don't think that's the type of thing that we should be playing around at the moment. I guess another Narset is probably better than Kazmina. Yeah, I suppose that's true. Narset does stop all that nonsense. Okay. So we can just Fae of Wishes for a sweeper if we'd like. I guess I can minus this to start. We don't need a second fire, so I guess it's probably Teferi. I mean, wishing for a Wrath makes a decent amount of sense. I'm trying to think what our alternative lands are. If we had a land on the board, this might be one of those spots where we'd wish for a land. Yeah. Oh, did I put Kaya's Wrath in? Oh, I didn't put Kaya's Wrath in. I forgot. So I could get Aether Gust and answer one of their threats that way. But yeah, I probably wouldn't have made this play had I known that or remembered that, I guess. I guess this one's probably better. Yeah, I guess we just do this, and then hopefully we can scry up a land. And I think we kill this, given that Narset's going to deny this pretty effectively. Okay, yeah, we'll take the land. And yeah, we can't play the Fae, unfortunately. Yeah, here's the thing, though. I think Fae of Wishes, 4 drawn from Dreams, is, like, really clunky. Like, I don't actually think that will come up very much. Okay, so next turn we can play a land, Scorching Dragonfire, the Arclight Phoenix. Oh, they're actually gonna... Interesting, they're not sure which one to go after. Yeah, this is not obvious for them. Yeah, so we'll play a land, crack it, just to thin, I guess. Because at this point, we don't want to draw lands. And we'll... Scorching Dragonfire, the Arclight Phoenix. Play Sarkhan. Make a dragon, and then we can bounce this guy to their hand. There's a chance that they can still play this guy and kick it, and then kill the Sarkhan. But given that we'll have already made a 4-4... And we're still doing the, like, play two cards a turn thing. And we even have a backup Narset to get down. This seems pretty good. Yeah, that's the thing. But, like, can I just get some, like, Gassy Planeswalker or something at that point? Like, wouldn't it be better to get, like, Nicol Bolas or, like... I don't know. Teferi. You can Teferi bounce the fires. Yeah, they are going to be able to take out Sarkhan. So is it better here to just bounce their guy again, or is it better to just get Narset down? Probably just Narset, right? Narset seems really obnoxious. I guess this would have been a reasonable turn to do the Teferi thing, right? Play Teferi, bounce fires, do some stuff. Because we could have gone play Teferi, then bounce fires, then play Narset and Shock plus Scorching Dragonfire, their Ironcrag. Yeah, maybe that was a good play. Really interesting. Yeah, maybe it was better to play around it. Okay, so this is going to be... Well, let's get Teferi down first things first. Because if we get this down, I believe we just have the check mark. Oh, they're going to kill Sarkhan in response. Interesting. Okay. Seems like they should have done that in my up... Oh, they let Teferi... Oh, yeah, they can't because of Narset. Okay, okay. So I believe we have a win here. What we need to do is play Fae of Wishes, use Fae of Wishes for free to get a non-creature from our sideboard. We get Chance for Glory. Now we can't play spells, but now we just pick up the fires. And then we can just cast the Chance for Glory. Boom. Yeah, wasn't that adorable? That felt pretty adorable. Yeah, that was sweet, right? So yeah, I need to look for that play more often because I think we could have done it last turn with Teferi bouncing the fires. I love that with my whole heart, yeah. Yeah, you know what? I think Nicol Bolas will actually be a good sideboard card. It seemed like it would have come up at least in one spot, and it just makes sense. I don't think we need two vetoes. Because boarding in Veto in a deck with fires sounds pretty awkward. These two seem like plausible board-ins. Okay, so we'll roll with this. And also worth noting that was score one for Kaya's Wrath. I was planning on getting a Kaya's Wrath, and I forgot that we cut it for Time Wipe because we wanted... Oh, land. I was going to put a land in the sideboard. We don't need both of these. We can probably cut the Gust. Is there... I guess the land that's in the sideboard... Oh, if we don't have four Fabled Passage, it should probably just be Fabled Passage, right? Because we're always going to have four lands in play by the time we use the Fae. And when you have four lands in play, Fabled Passage is just the best land, I think. Yeah, it could be a utility land, too. Time Twister, it's just because I was trying to build like a sideboard that made sense for traditional standard as well. The Blue Castle. Yeah, well, my only concern is if you're on four lands, some percentage of the time you just won't have an island. But yeah, Scry 2 is really good, and it does make a lot of sense with the fires, right? Yeah, the Blue Castle is a really good utility land. There should maybe even be some Blue Castles in the main deck. All right, we'll run the Blue Castle as the sideboard land. We'll see how often it tilts us. Oh, that's true. That's true. Yeah, each creature deals damage equal to its power. Oh, yeah. Well, if we have fires, we don't. If we just have a Sarkhan in hand or something, we do. Yeah, Blast Zone. I mean, the castle seems like a good compromise of, like, land that has a good ability, and maybe there should even be some small number of castles main. Have to see how good the mana in this deck is. I know casting the non-Planeswalker spells in these decks can be pretty awkward. Oh, you were playing Golos in like a Grixis Planeswalkers deck? Interesting. Alright, this looks good. So we know our Fabled Passage is going to be on. We have three other lands, so we're good to just play Foundry turn one. And we're playing against probably a mono black sacrifice-y deck, it looks like. So I think we can save Fae of Wishes. We probably want to play Shock this turn anyway. Only question is... Do we want to shock the priest immediately? I think I'd rather not give them the information. Burglar Rat? Whew! Did not see that coming. I think we can probably afford to discard a land. Well, maybe a Teferi?
We do have three Teferis. Teferi just seems so good that I'm like reluctant. Nah, we can discard a Teferi. That's fine. Alright, we'll just shock that. We can't bounce this one, so we'll just play Teferi and plus it. But that's still a good thing to have down. Yeah, this might be a game where we wish for the special land, actually. The perfect example. YXC, I haven't. If you have a good list for it, I might give it a try at some point. Well, I think Teferi is still the worst card in our hand. I think I'll discard another one. Oh, interesting. They're gonna put Priest back on top. I'm not actually particularly scared of the Priest. Is this thing an instant or sorcery? Okay, sorcery. Yerox Fenlurker? I assume that's another. Okay, well now we don't need to worry about getting the land. We can just get some sweet thing. What is a sweet thing to grab in a spot like this? Maybe Chandra? Chandra sounds pretty good. Yeah, we'll grab Chandra. Chandra has to be really good against them, right? Oh, we have Teferi! Oh! Good point, Malrus. Yeah, it's inherently a sorcery, but that means it's an instant with Teferi. I kind of had a feeling they had some Planeswalker removal spell based on the fact that they top-decked the Priest, but this still doesn't seem like it's working out all that well for them. So we have two red and two blue already, so we'll grab white. And then we can just jam Sarkhan. And we can just make a dragon. Then they can't even attack with their burglar rats. Yeah, pretty much that is what it means. Okay, this person just gave up. Yeah, they have the Witch's Oven with the cat, almost certainly. But didn't seem like they got there. All right, I think it's time. I think we can move on to the big leagues here. We can play some traditional standard. That'll be good because we're playing a creatureless deck with a wish board, which is about as bad as you can be in post-sideboard games, right? People are going to be able to board out all their creature removal, and we don't have much to sideboard in. Aggro decks, Terra decks. I think it's like the single best card against mono red. Yeah, they're just for actual sideboarding. I basically, like, even though we were playing in best of one, that was just kind of to get a feel. Oh, I still haven't updated the stream decker. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's true. You can fey for a counterspell. That is legit. Yeah, the rebuy combo does seem good. I did consider that. Yeah, we have one time wipe main and more in the board. Well, this is a really clunky draw, but it's hard to punish it too much, given our situation. I think we should just kill that. I think so. They're probably playing the stupid draw three deck, and they're gonna just like get pretty good value straight away. I think there's too good a chance of that. I would guess not, Eb. It doesn't look like good enough for modern, but I haven't thought about it too much. So this doesn't stop abilities. So if we play this in minus, they can just kill it with the Pyromancer. But I don't really see an alternative. And even though we have double Chandra, I think there's a decent chance we'd want to loot away a land here. Or at least, yeah, we can upgrade to all untapped lands. Yeah, you can always post lists here. I'll always take a look. I can't promise I'll play them on stream or anything like that, but I'm always at least down to take a look. I have a feeling if I attack here, they won't block, so I'm going to try it. This might also be a game where double Chandra comes up. Hey Gary, how's it going? Good to see you here again. Hi, Zlubars. But yeah, links are enabled here, so. Yeah, the only time I stream like at night is if Sam and BK want to do a night stream, which is more likely to happen with Eldraine, I think. Like, now that there's some new modern brewing we can do, I wouldn't be surprised. Fires is doing nothing? Well, it didn't do much that turn, but I think we'll have a pretty good turn this turn. So, okay, here's the question. Do we just double Chandra to clear the board? Or do we, like... We could go Teferi, free Chandra minus. Teferi, bounce our fires, free Chandra minus. We could go... We could just go Teferi, Bouncier, Pyromancer. Well, we should start with Teferi and see what they do, right? That has to be the way to start this turn. Well, because we have Teferi. They're not going to be able to do anything in response because we have Teferi. That's the good news. Yeah, we could just minus Chandra against the Drake. Oh, wow, they actually had to trigger the Pyromancer on our turn. Yeah, there's a lot of different ways to play this. It's pretty interesting. Okay, so let's think this through. So, okay, here's some options. Minus Chandra against the Drake. Minus Teferi on Pyromancer. Minus Chandra against the Drake, just plus Teferi and pass. Minus Chandra against everything, minus Teferi on our own fires, play new Chandra, minus on everything. Why not just double emblem into victory? It's safe. That is another option. We could also go like plus Chandra, minus Teferi on fires. Yeah, bounce Drake and plus. Maybe that's good. Maybe bounce Drake and plus is a good line. Yeah, that line's kind of growing on me. Maybe just put some pressure on their actual life total. Oh, that would have been a good one. I would have done something very different had I drawn that one, probably. But at this point, I think this is the best line. Yeah, Bounce Drake and plus does put a lot of pressure on them. And it keeps the second Chandra in our hand. Like, they might actually expend a lot of resources trying to deal with this Chandra. Yeah, it's a good tempo play for sure. Yeah, so now they can deal 6 to Chandra, which will mean it's out of range of minusing if they do that. But they'll probably want to kill Teferi. Yeah, okay. So now we can go minus Chandra and Clarion, potentially. Or we can just keep plussing and try to just, like, kill them that way. Upkeep. Can they draw 2 cards right now? Maybe they can draw 2 cards right now and kill Chandra. Yeah, they can. Wow. Very nice. Maybe we actually need to go Clarion minus Chandra here. Like, maybe these Pyromancers are a big enough threat that that's where we're at. We could also attack and then, like, see how that goes. Because it's pretty free. Now I think I like Chandra plus and Clarion. Wait, I don't want to pay mana on that if I don't have to. Yeah, sorry, Zubars. I didn't update the stream deck, or I keep forgetting. But after this game, I'll do it for sure. Do you run castles? There's currently a castle in the sideboard for the Fae of Wishes to get, but not castles in the main deck. But minus one the Chandra. Yeah, I was considering that too. I just feel like if I'm flooding out, so if I don't put pressure on their life total, I'm just going to lose. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe they could have gotten away with that. I can't really tell. Okay. So, I guess I should start with Teferi since it's kind of a natural starting point. I assume I should just bounce the Crackling Drake and just try to stack up Chandra emblems on them and win that way. Because they can't play spells on my turn right now, right? So this is going to be, like, super awkward for them. Like, how are they going to kill both of these things? It's not going to be easy. I could also shock their face right now, so I don't waste the spells. Yeah, three turn clock with the shock. You like shock place. So it's only relevant if I draw like a double spell. Like if I draw Fae of Wishes or I draw like Narset. I guess there's a lot of cards that do that. Yeah. What up? Shock you. Boom. Your turn. So now they take three down to six. But now like... So they can trigger Pyromancer now just by playing Crackling Drake. And then I guess they want to... take out Teferi so that they can like trigger Pyromancer on my turn. But I don't think they can stop Chandra from... I guess Chandra plussing isn't really a threat anymore. That's the thing. It might not be that much of a threat. Hold shock to kill Drake. I mean, the shock is going to reduce their clock by one. That seems pretty important. Now I guess I can just minus four Chandra on the Drake, right? Because, like... They're on a two-turn clock anyway. They don't have any life gain in their deck, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, they should have upkeep killed the Chandra, but maybe they felt like they couldn't afford to. That has to be it, right? And I'll just play this and minus it. It gains me a life at the very least, so... Also makes it... Yeah... They're dead. Got him. That felt good. That was a tough game. Yeah, but I didn't want to discard Kazmina to the loot unless I hit something really good. That's a thing. So Vantress Gargoyle, it doesn't seem like it'd be good against them. Devout Decree would probably be good against them. Can board that in. We can cut one Clarion. Yeah, this is a problem with this deck, right? It's going to be hard to sideboard. Chandra seemed pretty good. We can go to three of those. I don't think we need access to that in the sideboard. Board in some extra Narsets. Yeah, more than four. Is Vantress better than Deafening Clarion? I think Clarion is better. God, Eternals, we can't cast that if we don't have... Fires. I don't think you want cards that are like reliant on fires to be cast, but we can time wipe over a Clarion. We could also just board in a Veto. I don't think we'll tutor for it too often, and it is really good against them. And if we do have fires down, we'll just cast the Veto aggressively so that we won't have fires down. Yeah, all right, we sideboarded perfectly. This is the ideal deck. Can't be beaten. Brazen Borrower. Is that the, like, raid guy? I think Vantress is going to be much more important. Like, Vantress will just single-handedly destroy Mono Red. Oh, the bounce guy. Yeah, I mean, that guy is decent. This hand needs some help, but it's really good if we get there. And we do have a good amount of sources, I think. I guess white is our lightest color, but I still don't think it's too late. Okay, so we got there on the mana for Teferi, at least. I guess this is kind of awkward if they play Dreadhorde Arcanist. But if they play Electromancer, this playing Mountain will be pretty good. Nothing is also fine. And then I guess we go Island to probably maximize our options. Still need a true white source at some point. Oh yeah, I did not have a good understanding of the rules with KCI. I barely do now. No, now I actually do. But it took me a while to understand how the rules worked with KCI. So basically, I'll tell you what happened. We had tested KCI a lot, not knowing any of the weird interactions. Like, not knowing the, like, announce mana ability, pay for it, etc. None of that. Like, just was... Oh. Well, that is a reason to leave in Clarion. I mean, Shock will be a pretty good answer to that as well. Yeah. This is so awkward. Our mana is not ideal. But we can't just Teferi bounce that. It's too bad. We have to just make the inefficient mana play. Don't think we want to land right now. Yeah, we have to. We have to just shock it. It's an unfortunate line, but it's a clear line. So... yeah, I have no strong feelings on, Jeskai versus Grixis. I was going to try both today if I have time. Yeah, Fires plus Veto Wombo combo, for sure. We can Teferi bounce the Fires if we want to leave up Veto at some point. So yeah, we know they have Iron Crag in hand. But playing Fires and Teferi in the same turn is going to be a Wombo combo of sorts. They may have a counterspell here, but I'm just going to jam. Don't think we can afford to not jam here. Yeah, they did. Good beats. So basically, yeah, I'm trying to remember what it was like. Okay, so a white source would be great here, because it would be awesome to go, like, Teferi bounce your goblin. Nope, no such luck. Do we still Teferi bounce the goblin? Because I don't want to bounce the Crackling Drake especially, and if we do happen to spike a white source, it's just so good. We have, like, 12 white sources or something that come in untapped. Kind of want to do this. Yeah, let's just do it. Why not, right? No! Interplanar Beacon, why? So basically, MJ, like, on the Friday before GP Phoenix, the first GP where we all played KCI, told us, like, hey, someone on my stream while I was playing KCI said that there's this weird thing you can do, and he explained it to us. And then, so then in that tournament, we were doing it. But the thing he had explained to us wasn't quite the right thing. Or the way he explained it, we didn't understand it, right? I'm not really sure which. But the thing we were doing was sacking Scrap Trawler and Mirror Retriever to KCI while activating a Sphere. And that just isn't legal. You can't do that. I mean, you can do it, but it doesn't... The Scrap Trawler won't see the Chromatic Star die, so it doesn't work. So Clark Clan Ironworks. So we just didn't understand it. So that's what happened with that. But anyways, I think we just have to jam Sarkhan and make a 4-4 and hope that they don't have a way to punish us here. We haven't drawn our white source, and so we're not really in a position to make any, like... Yeah, non-arena card. Yeah. Someone was just asking about it in chat. Yeah, Gary was asking about it. Yeah, I won a lot of tournaments with it. I won two and top eighted two more, I think. Yeah, it's awkward that all their dudes have four toughness. We have a lot of DL3s to everything. Yeah, it got banned in Modern. Oh, I'll draw a time wipe? Yeah, that sounds about right. Yeah, we'll definitely want to trade off this dragon. Keep our life total high. Keep the board as clear as possible. I feel like we should just Teferi bounce the Iron Crag, probably, and try to peel a white one more time. Hopefully we can then decree... Nope. That's not allowed. Oh yeah, the second in Team Modern wasn't with KCI though. Yeah, they are making our bolts look pretty silly. These could be Lava Coils. I think it's pretty specific to this matchup, but these could be Lava Coils. Ay, ay, ay. So, I can Scorching Dragonfire the Royal Scion's end step. And then Scorching Dragonfire it again. It's not like the most appealing line in the world, but that might just be where we're at. Seems good to me. Well, it doesn't seem good to me, but it seems correct to me is, I guess, the right way to say it. So yeah, let's finish that off. And then let's just drop Kazmina. The Fae of Wishes, I don't think, has an obvious bullet here. Okay, here's Time Wipe, but we're not even close to that, even though it would be excellent if we could cast it. So I think we just discard it. I have a Plains in the sideboard? No, the land that I have in the sideboard is blue. This is a game where that would be relevant. I mentioned that maybe the land in the sideboard should be Fabled Passage, and I might get a Fabled Passage here with Fae of Wishes if I had it, so that's good to know. Definitely want to keep track of that sort of thing. If we draw a white, we can cast it. Time Wipe? Isn't it double white? Yeah, I assume if we draw fires, we can do something pretty good. Yeah. Yeah, if I had Fabled Passage, my play here would just be tutor up Fabled Passage. I guess Chandra can just minus X, right? Yeah, so we just kill Rawl with Chandra here. Yeah, sorry, Tempest, the deckless isn't. Yeah, Beacon doesn't help at all for non-planeswalkers, unfortunately. We're closer to casting Bolas than Time Wipe, yeah. Sad but true. Yeah, we just trade with Rawl here. But, I guess I have the Aether Gust in my sideboard still. Could be useful. Yeah, I thought about having a Fires in the sideboard, but I think just having... It's kind of like Sarkhan, right? They're both just A-plus cards that you could have access to in the board, or you could just play four main so you draw up more. Hey, Dokomoi. Yeah, I think I did add a Nicol Bolas to the side. So, can we actually cast that? We can't, right? Because these each make a black, but if we get one more Beacon, we can. That would be hilarious. Oh no, we use our Chandra and then Legion Warboss comes down. Wow, even the Pyromancer's getting in there now. Yeah, we drew Fires now, but it's gonna be too slow. They got us. We'll call. We'll call that one. I don't think we should change our sideboard. Whoops. Oh, we don't have Aether Gust. Oh, I cut Aether Gust from the sideboard. Okay. Do we want some number of Clarions now that we've seen War Boss? Yeah, Fires is very strong. The deck itself is like kind of medium, just because I think Jeskai Planeswalkers is only okay right now. But Fires is great. I might try Grixis. That's another option. So yeah, this game we have to go Evolving Wilds turn one since, or Fabled Passage turn one since we don't know what the story is. The blue castle is in the board right now. Yeah, Fires is a very hard card to build with. It might not even be that there is a right Fires deck, right? Like, it might be correct to play Fires in Jeskai Planeswalkers and in red-green midrange decks with Cavalier, and there's some sort of more combo-y Fires deck. Like, that is possible. The Teferi bouncing Fires thing seems like it actually comes up a lot. Like, it seems very real. One thing I noticed is it's kind of embarrassing to have Time Wipe and only one Planes in our deck for Fabled Passage. I would be really tilted if we drew a Time Wipe at some point, drew a Fabled Passage, and then couldn't cast it anyway. So that's something we might want to address. They have Spell Pierce? No way. Don't Spell Pierce me. And I think we plus here. If we minus and they play War Boss, I would feel pretty bad. Yeah, Op seems more likely. Oh, Spell Pierce might not be legal now. That's a good point. I didn't really think about it. Oh, Punished. That's kind of a punish. So this is actually going to be a kind of awkward spot. Because I don't want to reveal what we're getting with Fires. Or even decide. But I guess with Teferi Plus, we can actually do that. Oh no, we can't. We can't. Because Fires always makes you do it on your turn. So we have to just wish now. Yeah, Mystical Dispute. That is the legal version. Yeah, it's crazy not to do this now. So here are some options. Option one is the castle. Definitely a good option. Option two is the Elder Spell. Option three is like Nicol Bolas. Yeah, the only thing that I feel bad about with the castle is if we draw like a land next turn, I'll feel kind of bad about getting the castle over like Nicol Bolas or something we could slam alongside Sarkhan next turn. But yeah, castle makes a lot of sense. Yeah, reliable Sarkhan is pretty appealing. Also, we can just start activating the castle next turn, and that's very strong. Like, the castle is not a joke. It's a big deal. Okay, so they got to Nug Teferi there. So, okay, here's my intuition. My intuition is we play castle, then we play Sarkhan and plus it, hit Narset for four, and then bounce Pyromancer. Yeah. Another option is castle, Sarkhan minus, and just make a bunch of 4/4s and bounce the Pyromancer. Maybe that's better. Yeah, kind of liking double Sarkhan the more I think about it. Yeah, Sarkhan minus Sarkhan plus is also pretty good. Not opposed to that line either. I also need to figure out what to do with the stupid Teferi. I think we attacked Narset. Do I plus it? I guess making it so that it's hard to trigger the Pyromancer on our turn is really good. But also making them waste the mana to replay the Pyromancer is really good. The problem is if you, like, play Fae, bounce Fae, adventure Fae. That's your whole turn. It's a little clunky. This deck is kind of hard. Oh, it's very hard to play. You just have so many options. Yeah, not getting the drop. We'll plus. We'll just have faith that they can't do anything too disgusting. Another thing I could have done is scry main phase so we had more information about what we were drawing. But I feel like knowing how this turn goes could influence what we want to draw as well. Yeah, no value does feel bad. I'm not sure how bad it actually is, but I know it feels bad. Fae, bounce Fae, play tap 3. Bounce fire. Yeah, the problem then is then what are we going to wish for, right? Because then we won't have the fires in play. The stuff won't be free. So it feels like that's not going to work for that reason. I guess if we can find... One thing that might be worth thinking about is... Can we kill them, right? Is there a way to get access to the chance for glory? Because if that happens, then we're golden. So we can think about how hard it would be to access the chance for glory. Okay, end step. Scry. Oh, we drew a Fae. Okay, well that makes it really easy to access the chance for glory. And I guess Narset's probably a decent draw under that, but also they're just dead. Or are they dead? Oh yeah, they're dead because we Teferi bounce. I guess we don't even need to Teferi bounce Crackling Drake, right? They just take 8 and then they take 12. Yeah, winner, winner. I was kind of curious if we could have done it without this, but this definitely makes it easier. If you play fires again, you don't get two more spells. Yeah, let's think that through. Yeah, Chance for Glory comes up a lot. I know that if you have a wish board, you need that one. Yeah, Chance for Glory is mandatory. We've already gotten that one twice. But okay, let's think that through. So how is it going to work if we had tried to do the fancy thing? So play Fae, play Teff. Bounce Fae. We need 7 mana, right? To transmute the Fae, or adventure the Fae, and do the thing. Yeah, I think we need 7 mana. So I think it wouldn't have worked. Yeah, Sarkhan's always been really good in these type of decks. I guess now we just have enough lands that we can just... both Fabled Passages can just be untapped. Yeah, I mean, having access to a time... Like, cards like Chance for Glory aren't reliably good, but they are situationally excellent, which is exactly what you want in a wish board card. Yeah, we drew the Sacred Foundry. We should fix that. Also, I still didn't put it on the stream decker because I'm really bad at remembering that. Like, really, really bad. Oh, God. Well... We are getting kind of destroyed here. And this is an example of a matchup where not having a sideboard is going to feel pretty punishing. I kind of want to just cash mine in. They're playing a black deck, so they almost certainly have the rider. And like the bounce ability isn't going to be that good versus this person. I wonder if they're playing the deck with that enchantment where you have to sack a permanent. Because that card is also unbeatable for us. Yeah, the stacks deck. Yeah, we can never win if they're playing that deck, but I guess we'll try. Honestly, this game seems pretty unwinnable as it is. What's my middle name? My middle name is Levitt. It's, I guess, a pretty standard Jewish name. This is my mom's last name. Yeah, I mean, I don't mind showing them more stuff, so. Oh, Shock Teferi? Oh, somehow I forgot that. Did they minus it? Oh, I forgot that they minused it. I'm so stupid. Jewish Hakuna Matata? Why didn't I Shock Teferi? I was just kind of off this game as soon as I, like, saw the start. I played zero games with or against the Dokomoi. It looks cool. I can tell you that. No idea about good. Oh, I probably should have cracked that too. I'm just going to give up. I know it's pretty early to give up, but like they have the castle too, so they like also have a better late game engine. I just did not want to participate in that game anymore. Okay, so... Yeah, see, this is horrible. Like... We need to board out as many of these cards as we... Like, Clarion and Time Wipe just have to come out. So, like, Dovin's Veto, Chandra, the land can all come in. They... Oh, exile target creature or planeswalker that's black or red. I don't think they have any planeswalkers that are black or red in their deck. We could put Chance for Glory in, but I want to leave that one to wish for. So I think we just play two gargoyles as, like... potential beatdown things if they can mill enough cards. That's how desperate we are here. Yeah, Time Wipe does something after they dance. We could do the Time Wipe over the gargoyles, but I think it's really bad. If they dance us, they're just gonna draw so many cards off it. Yeah. Yeah, it's the Jewish New Year. Yeah, I'm not particularly religious, but I am vaguely aware. I actually speak a little bit of Hebrew because I went to Jewish school for elementary. So I took like 6 years of Hebrew, but it was long enough ago now that I've forgotten a lot of it. So, kind of brutal, I guess. Ooh, this hand is good. This hand is good. We actually have a good one. Did you do Birthright? No, I never did. I do, yeah. My mom's from South Africa and I've also never been there. So I kind of want to run like South Africa plus Israel, one trip. And I think I have family in both places even. It was pretty good, yeah. I think if I went to Israel, I would just like, I do think I'd rather do something on my own. I mean, the free part is pretty appealing, but like I'm friends with Shahar and he lives in Israel at least some of the, I guess he's mostly in the US now, but he goes there pretty regularly. And, like, I have some family there, and so, like, yeah, I don't know. Oh, Tel Aviv was sweet? Yeah. Okay, confirmed they're playing the Stax deck. We kind of figured that, but now we have true confirmation. Narset should be good against that, but I think it's safe. If they have Oath of Kaya, they have Oath of Kaya. I'm still just going to minus it. Teferi or Dovin's Veto? I guess Teferi bouncing the enchantment is pretty appealing. Oh, Huey's playing it right now? Yeah, there you go. Yeah, I'm sure lots of people are... Oh, wait, I should... I guess it doesn't really matter. I think it takes the eye off either way, but... Might as well. Let's just ditch Shock. It's gotta be our worst card. Yeah, I guess I don't know how easy... How good they... Like, if they have the... The card that I was most scared of with leaving Narset up was the Rider, right? If they have the Knight that just heroes downfalls, I would feel really stupid for not minusing Narset. At least this way I'm always getting a decent value trade. Oh, so this requires you to sack non-creature permanents. Okay. Wow. I guess Teferi bouncing it is good, and then I can sack the Teferi. It doesn't feel that great, though, because, like, now we had to sack and they didn't. But I guess they had stuff to sack anyway. Oh, non-token, not non-creature. Okay, yeah, I thought it killed creatures. I see, yeah, non-token makes a lot of sense. I guess we just keep trying to, like, pressure their life total. Because I don't think there's much to Fae of Wishes for here. So we just make a dragon. Yeah, it might be a good thing to prevent them from sacking, actually. If we get a Chandra emblem on them, that might be pretty annoying for them as well. How good is the trigger? They discard a card, lose 2 life, you draw a card, gain 2 life, get a 2-2 knight token. Yeah, that's a lot of stuff. Yeah, that's true. The eggs, at least, are easy to sack. The Oath of Kaya, not as easy. But you can legend rule that one pretty easily as well. Alright, well, we drew the land for Chandra. We might just kind of kill them. I don't know how easy it is for them to, like, gain life. They also might have to sack their own Doom Foretold if they can't come up with more stuff here. But yeah, I'll just put an emblem on them. They have a bunch of food. Okay. I mean, they certainly don't at the moment, so I like that part. Oh, Teferi is a good answer to the dragon. I'll say that. But we won't. I don't think we have to deal them that much more combat damage before the two Chandra emblems become pretty problematic. Like, I'm pretty sure this this token should go face. Oh no, if I kill this, then they sack this, right? Isn't that pretty good? Yeah, we should kill Teferi. Yeah. Flaming Gnome, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime sub. Really appreciate it. And welcome to the combo crew. Okay, so they had... they had another one of these in hand, but they still have double emblem on them. Oh, they're gonna get the trigger right before they would run out of life. Savage. They managed to run us out of... oh no, they're gonna lose their Doom Foretold. Never mind. Yeah, this is great. Yeah, they sack it. True, true, true. So we got there? Or did they have the dance? Oh, it looks like they might have the dance. Because they're fiddling with their graveyard. I wonder if they just drew it or they had it. Yeah. It looks like they have the stupid dance. Tilt. It's only for 5, I guess. Yeah, it's going to buy them some time. But, oh, maybe I should have played a land because now they can dance back both Doom Foretolds and then I lose everything. Oh, they got Oath of Kaya. Okay. So they do have a little bit of life to work with. Because this will give them 2 life as well, right? Oh, this only gets different ones. Yeah, so they're up to 9. I guess I'll just keep cards in my hand. That's still a 5-turn clock, though. Oh, you can get... Oh, but Doom Foretold doesn't stack that way? Or do they just not want the Doom Foretold? I don't get it. Oh, the egg itself can sack for 3 life too. Okay, so it's a 5-turn clock still. You think they just messed up? Okay. Yeah, that would have been a lot harder to beat, so. Yeah, they paid 5 on X, I thought. They must have at least paid 4, and they only got 3 things. Oh, well, they drew another dance. Yeah, we can pack it in here. I think they'll be able to race the Chandra emblems pretty easily. I guess maybe I should have still tried. Because they would only have 2/2s, they would lose the 4/4s, right? Oh yeah, okay. Let me add planes and get this on the stream decker since it's been far too long. And then also was that best of 1? No, that was best of 3. Yeah, it was a little premature. I think I was probably like 10% to win that game or something. Which is low, but not so low that I shouldn't probably play at least another turn or 2 and just see how things are going. I was just a little tilted. Okay. All right, Stream Decker should be on the play. Do I keep this? Yeah, the mana in this deck is always a at least mild issue. I think I do. I hate mulliganing and Sarkhan is busted, so. Yeah, if they had gotten back both Doom Foretolds with the first one, it would have been yeah, it appears to be working. I guess if we draw another Beacon, we still can't play Narset. That's kind of funny. Ooh, I'm pretty glad I kept against a Thought Erasure deck. Generally don't want to mulligan against those. Is this my same opponent from last time or different? I don't remember. Well, I definitely have to minus Narset here because we don't really have a 4-drop to play. And if they don't have a way to kill Narset, I really want to take two looks at that. I also just think with the knight in the format, you should kind of just always minus Narset. Obviously, it sucks if it gets Oath of Kaiad, but it is what it is. We also don't know if we're playing against Planeswalkers or the dance nonsense. Oh, you can't see my opponent's names? Yeah, that's true. Good beats, good beats. All right, well, we have some pretty good plays. We're skipping a turn, obviously, but we have good plays coming up. Yeah, damn, Doom Foretold seems so obnoxious. Oh yeah, we're pretty Thought Erasure proof. We are quite Thought Erasure proof. We do have that going for us, I suppose. Yeah, I mean, I think you can just play Esper Planeswalkers or Esper Hero or whatever. Yeah, I mean, there are worse things you can do than play Sarkhan every turn, right? This is one of the problems with Thought Erasure. It's obviously a great card. But, yeah, okay, it is in fact dance again, so I don't know if it's the same person, but either way, confirmed they are in fact dancing. That was probably a decent draw. Yeah, exactly, it puts you in a real catch-22. I mean, I guess it's just supposed to be a good anti-control card. It's bad against aggressive decks. Oh, I could sack Fires here, actually. But Sarkhan on 2 is 4 damage. That's a lot of damage. So, okay, let's think this through. If we sack Fires, we hit them for 8, play a new Sarkhan, make a token. And then we're not really threatening much. If we sack Sarkhan, we hit them for 4, make 2 Sarkhan tokens, and then I think we are threatening lethal. Yeah, I think Sarkhan is the sack. Fires is also great if we draw like Fae of Wishes or something. I don't know. It feels like Fires gives us more outs as well. It's just better against the Doom Foretold. Because now that we've like played all our crap, we can sack it, and it will be pretty appealing too. In before Legion's End, yeah, that would not be ideal, but you can't play around everything. We're not... If you're winning, you can try to play around stuff, right? But if you're in a position like this where you're in a tough spot, you just kind of have to jam. Oh, interesting. Yeah, I mean, if other people have, like, eggs in their deck or stuff like that, that does seem pretty annoying. Yeah, it seems like the longer you let the game go, the worse it is. Does not seem like you're very likely to kill this deck on turn 20. So, yeah, probably a Mono Sarkhan hand is actually a good hand to have against them. Planar Cleansing. Oh... Was not aware they had that one. Okay, well, Kazmina's not the worst draw after a Planar Cleansing. Yeah, if they have Doom Foretold, it's going to be... Or if they have the Doom Foretold or the early way to reanimate it, it's going to be really bad for us. Sort of punished for playing that land. Cleansing is a one of, usually. Okay. For Kaya's Wrath, one cleansing. Yeah, Kaya's Wrath would have been annoying, but not catastrophic. Cleansing is... Okay, the list of one fandom played one cleansing. Yeah, Brian Gottlieb's. Oh, I punished for playing the land because I looted with Kasmina. Okay, I see. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's true. I did see... I think Gottlieb had Witchclaw, yeah. Yeah, I kind of want to give up this game, too, just because this feels so bad. Yeah, this deck's sweet. Doom Foretold is very powerful. It's just so unfun to play against. That's unfortunate. I like when cool decks like this exist, but I prefer if they're at least not horrible to play against. And this feels legit bad. Yeah, like this game, right? Like, if I shock Teferi, I can play on. And it's like... Yeah, I mean, I guess I could win, but... Yeah, exactly. It's like, it's a very expensive way to, like, draw cards every turn, but that's still pretty good. Or if you already have a Teferi, yeah, you can Demonic Tutor and then bounce it. Yeah. Yeah, Knight seems like a deck that has pressure, plenty of fodder to sacrifice. Like, that does seem like a tough matchup. Yeah, maybe if I just leave Narset on 5, they would have trouble. If we assume all Esper decks are going to be that version. I guess I really should keep playing, because they've just cantripped off a bunch. Maybe they just flooded out. Yeah, it seems like the type of deck that should have polarized matchups. Yeah, they did draw a lot of eggs. Yeah, another argument for Grixis, for the Planeswalker deck, is we'll have access to Thought Erasure. Obviously, like, a super important card. I guess the biggest problem with Grixis is you lose Clarion, so your sweepers are a lot worse. Teferi is also obviously a beyond busted card that you don't get access to. Oh yeah, the event... Yeah, I think that's also all four Teferis that they've drawn. That's pretty funny. Yeah, Cry and Soot are playable. They're not as good as... I guess Fires into Ritual of Soot is probably a pretty good feeling. I want to give up so badly, but they really haven't done anything. This is painful. Oh, I should probably sack these Fabled Passages. Yeah, that's true. It would be better against the X4. Yeah, I mean, it'll also kill some of the, like, 3-mana 4-4s and stuff like that that exist now in, like, mono green and stuff. I don't know. Rotting Regisaur is a card that has seen some play. Yeah. Maybe this deck needs more of the Scry land. It does seem like a very good combo with Fires and just mitigates flooding. Maybe if I try the Grixis version, I'll try to play some Scry lands. I can't even imagine what I'd get here to get out of this situation, but we can look at what we have access to. I mean, there's at least a Chandra, right? Oh, we can actually play Nicol Bolas. I don't know how good it is, but we can play it. Oh. Yeah, we could have a Tamiyo on the Wish sideboard at least. Oh yeah, on Mordigo. Yeah, that's a good point. That's another argument for the Grixis version, I guess. Yeah, let's see what Nicol Bolas can do. We happen to have drawn three beacons, so we might as well, right? Doesn't happen every day. Somehow we ended up with a white floating. I feel like that can't have been. Oh, I guess it is how it has to work. Yeah. I guess draw is probably just you draw a card and they exile. Oh no, maybe killing Teferi. Yeah, killing Teferi sounds like a good start, given that it's about to do that thing. Thought Distortion, which one's that? Exile on non-creature, non-land cards from that player's hand and graveyard. Master S. Yeah! It's not crazy. Yeah. If we could get Tamiyo and Narset going, that would be pretty good. Well, achievement unlocked. We did hardcast Nicol Bolas. I consider that a pretty big achievement. You need three interplanar beacons for that. Oh, they have Veto in the main deck. Okay. Well, I guess we can play this guy. I mean, maybe that was bad. We probably didn't want to play him until we had two cards in hand, right? Yeah, that was probably a mistake. Yeah, the Master S thing doesn't sound horrible, but it sounds a little narrow. Maybe it could get there. Alright, well I guess we can poke him for one, and then pick up the Fae, do it all over again. It is nice that the Fae just gets rid of all your bad cards. What? Oh no! I clicked the wrong side. Ugh. That ain't great. I was gonna get Chandra, so I couldn't even play it this turn, but I still wanted to get it. Yeah, I mean, I still feel like they also didn't scry again. Shame concede. Yeah, okay, well, we don't actually have to shame concede. We can concede for real now, because they're about to dance for a lot. In fact, I'm not even going to give them the satisfaction of casting it. They don't deserve it. Oh, they put it on the stack right as we conceded. I'm going to run to the restroom real fast in between games. I guess we'll sideboard same as last time. We do this. Yeah, I don't feel like Ashiok is what we want, but it's not horrible. Wow, Dokomoy, you did it too? Oh no. Well, this is not really the hand you want in this matchup. I think this might be one of those games where we don't play Passage on turn one, even though we don't have four lands. Just because I don't know what color to get. We need red for Narsa, but I also want white at some point. Maybe Snosna? I mean, I would bet against it, but it would be cool. All right, let's see how fast we can make this thing attack. Probably not very fast. Also, milling our opponent could be kind of bad, given that they're playing Dance. This might have been a bad card to bring in. Maybe we should have just had two time wipes. It does pressure Planeswalkers, though. Oh boy, our opponent found out how bad our hand is. Ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. What has been the best decks you've played against? I mean, all the Oko decks are good, and this Dance deck seems good. Those are, I guess, the two decks that have impressed me the most. Yeah, the Faber Elder is cool. So basically there's like a 3-mana aura that can untap it for 3, and then if you can make it tap for more than 3 mana, you get infinite mana. Someone did that against us with Leyline in the streamer preview event thing. Oh wow, they're gonna let us just kill the Teferi. That seems like a punt. I think I will just use the Gargoyle. I think we should just try to get to 7 cards in graveyard. It's tilting that this exiles. I actually don't want it to exile. It's kind of funny. Oko or Teferi 3? Yeah, that is a pretty broad question, and it's hard to say, but... Yeah, which is more busted? I guess if I had to guess, I would guess Teferi 3, just because I've played... I'm confident about how busted Teferi 3 is, whereas Oko is going to be, like, harder to evaluate, right? But... It could be that Oko is better in standard. Yeah, maybe I need to try to build a Planeswalker deck with Oko. Because the Tameo thing does sound good, too. Is Temur Planeswalkers the solution? Have we been doing it wrong this whole time? Oh, whoops. Oh, whoa. Alright, I'm gonna concede not out of shame, but because we're just losing that badly. We could try Temur. Fires in a Gates deck? Maybe. My problem with Fires in Gates is that, like, I don't know, it feels like it might make Gates even more clunky. Like, you're a coward if you're not playing 5 colors, TBH. Let's try it. Fires and Gates. I'm pretty skeptical. Because, like, what are you casting that's so good off the fires? Anything thick? You want to go like Fire Circuitous Route and then play like a big thing? Yeah. Yeah. Should we actually try Temur? Is this a troll or is this actually a good idea? Because we could do it. Yeah, that's the problem, the 20 taplands thing. Taplands are just so, like, you need to make up for it big time if you're going to play with 20 taplands. Yeah, maybe this one's like a little more explosive and it does the like goose grazer stuff. I mean, goose unfortunately is like pretty awkward if we're whatchamacallit-ing? If we're Fire Zing, because it doesn't make lands. Yeah, so it might be Growth Spiral and Grazer that you want for this version. Yeah, could this be Ghastly? I think we still want the Fae of Wishes. I wonder if we even need a sweeper. Oh, Sarkhan is our only red card. Yeah, that's true, Narsa Confined Spiral. Like, Nissa is not that much worse than Sarkhan, and it's kind of awkward to have... Oh no, we're gonna play Fires, right? Yeah, we're gonna play Fires. What am I talking about? Okay, so this would be the right number of cards if we were playing 20 lands, but we're not. We want to play, like, 27, maybe? So, we can play three of each of the five drops. Then we can actually put one in the Fae sideboard, too. That's kind of nice. Yeah, and I see what you're saying, Wikipedia, but I think with Fires, that's, like, unacceptable, right? Like if we turn three of Fires, then we can't play Tamiya with it. That's going to be a feel bad. The Grazer is also so good with Oko. I guess the Goose is too. The Goose is a much better card. Maybe I'm being wrong. You can also just cast the cards. Like, you don't have to play the cards for free with Fires. Can't find Fae with Fae. Yeah. Should we try the Goose? Is the Goose just better than the Grazer? The Goose does also give us access to other colors of mana. That could be nice. We could play three Fires in this version, then just have one in the sideboard too. I don't know. I mean, the Goose is such a bad card. Like, it's better with Oko, but you can also just do other stuff with Oko. Yeah, maybe we just play three Fires, and then we'll have access to it in the... Oh, I guess it's going to make Tamiya work if we have a bunch of three ups, but that's not that big a deal. And do we just play three Tamiya as well? Is this the perfect build? Well, you can't sack the stupid food, because it's non-token. Oh, play Chandra 6. We could play one Chandra 6 just to keep it interesting. And then sideboard, we'll put a Chandra, and we'll also put a Sarkhan and a Nissa and a Fires. And a Tamiyo. So yeah, we'll just put an extra copy of a bunch of our main deck cards. And then we also want some sort of sweeper. We should probably have Flame Sweep so that we have one that we can cast kind of on the regular. And then we can just have like Kaya's Wrath as our kind of uncastable one. Ego is something that we can cast some of the time and might be good. What else did we have? Oh, that's cool. Oh yeah, we definitely need Chance for Glory. Probably want some sort of counterspell. I guess in this version it has to be Negate. Yeah, don't think we want Clarion or Teferi 3. Nicol Bolas did seem good in spots. We did tutor for it once. Although I don't know that this version will play Beacon, so the Hardcast Dream might be dead. And it, I guess this version. No, we're still three. We're just teamer. Mass Manip? Yeah, Mass Manip sounds legit. That sounds like something that we would find some of the time. It's not the best with fires, but still could just be a good thing to have access to. And then we can play some actual... We could try three Vantresses. I still like having something for Mono Red. Oh no, we need the land. Yeah, we should play one of these in the board. And then I think we should try to play like two of these main. This card seemed excellent. So I want to play that. I think this deck might not want as many Interplanar Beacons because like we have turn one Goose Considerations. Probably still do want all the shocks. And maybe some blue-red temples. Probably not the green temple since our green should be untapped for the most part. We could even try to go like heavy on the blue-red temple. Yeah, how many beacons do you play in this one? And not play Fabled Passage. Yeah, I'm a little skeptical of Drawn from Dreams. So yeah, the temple and the forest will kind of counteract a little bit. So yeah, the 12 shock should balance out. Maybe we play less of this. And now we're at 13 turn one greens. We're a little light on red now, right? 4, 8, 10. Yeah, that's too light. We might just need to play even less beacons. Yeah, Lovestruck Beast over Gargoyle, is that better? I think against Mono Red, the Gargoyle is still better, just costing 2. Slash Knights, probably. Oh yeah, Nissa, maybe Nissa is the cut, right? Like, maybe we're just... We just shouldn't Nissa. Like, Sarkhan is just better. We should just play 4 Sarkhans main. Oh yeah, this was built for 24. Okay, that... I was wondering, like, I feel like our mana should be okay. Something like that. Now we have 14 turn 1 greens. We have 12 reds. Plus the Gilded Goose. Yeah, this looks a lot better. But I am wondering if Nissa is actually good. I guess we have 14 forests. Yeah, we're not the best at using the Nissa mana, especially if Fires is out, but we should be okay at it. Like Tamiyo and Narset and stuff, the Fae of Wishes, like, we should be okay. Alright, we'll try this. It's probably bad and... Oh wait, we should just craft the... I think it's one of the lands, which I'm definitely down to craft. We'll export it. Let's hop in. Yeah, I don't know about that, but it looked interesting. Yeah, only 8 island for castle is a bit awkward, but... the castle seemed really good, so I still want to play it, and I didn't see an obvious way to add islands. I mean, I'm not going to mulligan this. It's not necessarily the fastest hand in the world. Yeah, I think Cavalier of Flames in a deck like this that doesn't have creatures in it is going to be pretty bad. But definitely worth looking at, like, Fires Cavalier decks. We should definitely look at those at some point. But I think today is a Planeswalker stream. So we're gonna try like pretty Planeswalker heavy decks where the Cavalier probably won't be good. This is a Narset deck mostly. Okay, I guess they're probably like banned, like turn two Oko slash Yeah, Sarkhan makes creatures. Yeah, I mean if you Sarkhan plus Cavalier, it could get pretty nutty. I do concede that. If you play turn 4 Fires, play like a Tamiyo, then go Sarkhan, Cavalier, plus animate the Tamiyo, and then like haste everything. It could get pretty nutty. Oh, they're Abzan?
Wonder what's going on here.
A part of me almost wants to just play Gilded Goose here. Because getting the fires down will just net us so much mana. Yeah, we can do that. Oh, yeah, they're probably playing a Wolves deck. Maybe playing Goose is bad then, because they'll just Toll Smear it. Yeah, that's a good call. This probably is Wolves. Yeah. By the way, this card, Curious Pair, everyone's playing it. It looks unplayable to me. I don't get it. It seems so bad. Someone has to explain it to me. Yeah, see, this is the type of thing that I was scared of with the Goose, right? It's not going to help us in a spot like this. I guess Oko is probably better than Sarkhan right now. No, they're not reanimating the troll. I don't think it's borderline. I think it's just unplayable. Hot take: in 3 months from now, no one will play with Curious Pair. There you go. Bold statement. Not even in troll decks? Yeah, I mean, the Feasting Troll King deck that I was playing wasn't playing it. There's such good food producers. The Gilded Goose gives you a food for one mana and also gives you a Birds of Paradise answering that can create more food. That's not even mildly warm. I mean, the format's not going to change at all. It's got to be at least a little bit warm, like lukewarm or something. Yeah, this is getting a little problematic. I guess having a 3-3 blocker is pretty appealing here, so I should probably just turn the Goose into a blocker. No, in this case, Grazer wouldn't be good either. Oh, make food with the Goose and turn the food. Yes, that does make sense. That is just strictly better. Ha ha ha, they didn't get a card off there, Garrick. Suckers. And they have 8 damage, but they can't spread it perfectly, so something will live. Yeah, so I could still have the Goose if I had done this better. My bad. So we can Fae of Wishes for Kaya's Wrath at some point. That seems like something that we might want to do. Oh. Well, the Great Henge seems like something. Oh, we can turn it into a 3-3, right? Wow, Oko's stupid. I guess let's Growth Spiral to start. I just want to try and draw a land. No reason to put that in on tap since we get all the value anyway. Yeah, we turn this into a 3-3. It's so sad they did all that work to play the Great Henge and then it just becomes a 3-3. So I guess what we need to do is we need to hit a Fae of Wishes, right? So we just Tameo plus for Fae of Wishes. No, we bricked. You can't get, if you're talking about the agent that's a creature, you can't get creatures with the Fae. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, the goose does seem pretty good in this deck.
actually. It's not fully a non-bow with fires, as much as I was making it out to be. Yeah, I assume they're going to kill both planeswalkers here. So each of these put a counter on Garruk when they die. And then if you emblem Garruk, creatures you control have +3/+3 and trample. Okay. So if we wrath them, they could emblem Garruk and just still lose. That's kind of nice. So even though the wrath will allow them to... it won't be a big deal. Kill Narset on one over Oko. I don't remember the spot. But I'm sure they had some sort of a reason. How much power do they have in play? 3, 5. Oh, because, yeah, we can also get to Chandra minus, potentially, if we can just survive for a minute here. Yeah, we can play a land, Tamiyo back Sarkhan, make a 4-4, something like that. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, 18, 21. Okay, so even with a blocker, we're dead. Yeah, I thought we Narset it into Oko as well. So let's think. What gets us out of this? Oko, make a food and gain 3. Yeah, so if we could Oko and play a blocker, that would do it. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, 18, 20, 23. So yeah, we're dead exactly if we do that, or if we present a blocker. We need something better than that. And I can Tamiyo plus to try and find it, I just can't think of anything. I don't think there's anything in our deck that, like, does it. And you can't, and we can't Fae of Wishes once we've played something. Oh, Gilded Goose! Gilded Goose is what we need. Of course. Of course it's the Gilded Goose. Why would it be anything else? Wait, oh, I had a Gilded Goose in my graveyard. Why did I plus? Okay, well, that's justice. I should have just minused on the Gilded Goose, right? Well, we're dead. Oh, scry first? Yeah, I could have scryed first, but I could have just minused on... No, if I scry first, I die, because then I can't crack the treasure I make, or the food I make. But I should have just minused. And then I would have had an out for a land. Damn. Punted. I don't think we sideboard in this matchup. We'll just run our main deck back. Yeah, we shouldn't scry first, but we should have minused. Somehow I thought of it a second too late. Yeah, maybe you do need some sweepers in the main. Things do just get pretty ugly when you play... Yeah, but a food wasn't enough. We needed food plus blocker. That was the problem. We were at 23, so if we just make a food, we still take lethal. No worries. It's a good question. I'll never get mad at you for asking a question. Or at least rarely. No, I think it's pretty close to never. Unless it's a really rude question. Oh, someone that we cast fires against just tweeted that they were scared. That's pretty funny. They were scared that we cast fires against them. Yeah. Since they banned KCI? Yeah. Is KCI getting banned is a question that I was asked a lot. Maybe I did get a little bit tired of that one. Okay, we got Oko. Or am I supposed to say Owo or something? I don't really get it. So yeah, I think I have to make a food here. If I get the opportunity. Oh, they have negate. Okay. Oh, that question. Yeah, that question did get asked a lot. That was getting pretty old pretty fast. Also, what is our mana base? All these forests are good for playing the goose on turn one, but not much else. All right, I think Teemer is not the way to play the Planeswalkers. Because the thing is, this card also just isn't as good in a Planeswalker deck as it is in like a more creature-y deck, right? Because like the Nissa part of it will be more relevant. Sort of adventure for the Scryland here? It would allow us to cast Narset at least. Oh, they're playing Wolves, so they have Night Pack Ambusher. I forgot that was a thing somehow. Well, that's embarrassing. I haven't actually played against the Wolf deck yet, so... Wasn't really expecting that one, even though I probably should have been. Yeah, let's just pick up the castle. Yeah, no sweeper seems pretty awkward. The like mono forest to support the goose seemed pretty awkward, and like Oko doesn't actually seem that good in a deck like this. Like it's better in other decks. The other thing is with these Planeswalker decks is there's a lot of haste in standard right now, right? Like Oko, the new 4-mana 4/4 guy, like maybe Planeswalkers is just not the right approach. As sad as that may be. Yeah, Dawn of Hope, Ethereal Absolution type things. Yeah, those type of things would be good for dumping the mana. Also, nice Great Henge loser. Yeah, this card is so stupid. My opponent works so hard to play the Great Henge, and it's just going to be a 3-3. That's not fair. I know I'm not supposed to root for my opponent, but that's not fair. They don't deserve that. Yeah, I mean, it's still great in this deck. It's just, the card is an 11, so it's, like, in the decks where it fits, then a 9 in the decks where it doesn't, right? It's just a ridiculous card. But to the extent that it's bad anywhere, it seems bad here. We don't make, like, random food and stuff like that on a regular basis, and it just, yeah, I don't know. It's just awkward. Yeah, it's the Oprah of 3-3s. Oh, damn, the pump. Couldn't they have done that pre-combat and then killed both Planeswalkers? They probably forgot about the pump. Yeah, they forgot about the Nightpack Ambusher pump. They could have blown me out really badly there. Wow. Well, that was fortunate. This is a pretty good pickup. I guess another Narset is a decent pickup. If I leave up the breeding pool, then I can play Nissa, play Fae of Wishes, and still have a land available to block. Probably should just be a forest given our mana situation. Yeah, wow, our Narset could have already been dead. I mean, we just Narset into a Narset, which wasn't the most relevant draw, but... Yeah, I mean, Oko's just so ridiculous that it's going to be good in every deck. Honestly, at this stupid Star City that I'm playing, I'm just pretty likely to play with Oko. Regardless of situation. Oh, yeah. Yeah, someone sent me a Scryfall Search last stream with every activated ability. And I was looking through them. Oko Windfree. Oof. It's a bit of a stretch, but I kind of like it. I assume trading 3-3s is a good thing. It makes their Wicked Wolves a little less effective for starters. It does cut me off of a little mana. But yeah, I think it's a good idea. Oh, interesting. Yeah, Field of the Dead is like a threat that can't be Oko'd, right? So there is definitely a little bit of value there. Yeah, like
This is the problem. Planeswalker decks are just gonna fall behind and ugh, so rough. This is another deck that has a lot of 4/4s, actually. That's worth noting. Like, this is another deck where Lava Coil might be relevant, and Deafening Clarion might not be that good. Although Ritual of Soot wouldn't have killed anything on that board either. Alright, well, we can scrap Teemer. Teemer's no good. Or at least not Teemer Planeswalkers. Yeah, you can definitely build a creature. I was just trying to build Planeswalker decks today, and I thought Teemer might be good just because of how busted Okro is. And people were saying, oh, Tamiyo could be good against that Doom Foretold deck, which made sense, but... I played against no aggro. Yeah, no mono red, no knights, no nothing. Yeah. So yeah, Grixis is possible, but is it just going to have the same problems? It's still going to have hasty things attacking its Planeswalkers. Also, Grixis has really bad 3-mana Planeswalkers, right? It has Narsetim and that's it. Bant? Yeah, then you don't get Sarkhan or Fires. Like, the whole point was to try to abuse Fires. Vraska eats the food? Yeah, that is cute. Oh, Shulane? Yeah, that could be fun. Play white so you can wrath. Yeah, I mean, the Jeskai one seemed like it might be the best. Yeah, no, the mana isn't a big deal. Jeskai and Grixis both seem like they'll have at least okay mana. Yeah, this was where we were at with the Jeskai one. And then with this kind of a sideboard. Grixis, I feel like... Yeah, they're... I guess in Grixis, you probably just play... In Grixis, you probably just play, like the Hero's Downfall guy, right? The knight. So you're kind of doing that on turn three. Yeah, let's at least look what... I might call it a stream here, but let's at least look what Grixis would look like before we call it. Because, yeah, none of these are good, right? Yeah, none of those are good. Are any of the multi-Grixis Planeswalkers good? Oh, there's not even very many. Yeah, Ashiok is... Yeah, Grixis has really bad Planeswalkers. So if you're playing black... Oh, it's exactly Nicol Bolas that's good. Yeah, Nicol Bolas is good. But is it even better than Sarkhan? I guess if you're playing black, Yeah, probably a Fires deck. Liliana's okay, but it's not much better than Chandra. And, like, Nicol Bolas is okay, but it's not much better than Sarkhan, right? So, like, if you're playing a Grixis Planeswalkers deck, it's because you think Thought Erasure and the Hero's Downfall Knight are good. Which is true, but it doesn't sound enough true to me. Yeah, my initial ruling is that Jeskai is the way to go with Planeswalkers. And that... It should probably be something like this. Emergency powers? Yeah, I thought about that one. It's kind of funny, but you'll draw 7, then you won't be able to play very many of them. What do you want blue for? Could you play Mardu? The Fae of Wishes is really good with fires, and Teferi is really strong. But you could consider, like, Mardu. Have you considered Karn's Bastion? I think the blue Scryland, the castle, is probably better, but... Are there any time walks you can play off fires? Chance for Glory. You have to win the next turn, so it's a little too narrow to play main deck, I think, but it's really good in the, like, Fae of Wishes sideboard. I really liked it there. Because, yeah, I think Jeskai is going to be the best. Teferi is just a busted card, and the Teferi Fires combo actually felt very good. Like, playing two spells for free and then unlocking the fires by bouncing your own fires actually felt like a line that came up a decent amount. And the Fae of Wishes is good, so I think you need to be blue. And Clarion also feels like it does give you some security. I think this list has a little too much removal, especially given that if you're going to have the Fae of Wishes sideboard, you're not going to have as much room for things to board out. So, like, having this many narrow cards, like, when you play against a creatureless deck, having to board out, like, Deafening Clarion, Time Wipe, and then having Shocks and Dragonfires that you just have to leave in is a pretty big feel bad. This deck also probably has enough anti-aggro stuff that these Vantress Gargoyles should just be anti-control cards so that you can make sideboarding a little smoother. But yeah, I'm going to call it a stream here. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'll find someone to throw a raid to. We can raid. We can raid Huey. I don't think I've raided Huey in a while. So yeah, thanks for watching, everyone. And yeah, I think this Jeskai deck has some potential. It's pretty sweet, at least. And yeah, we'll be back on Monday trying some more stuff. I'm playing Standard in the Star City in a week, so I do need to figure it out pretty quickly.